Welcome back, everybody.
All right, we just finished doing a lab using DNS to do name resolution with the DNS server. So we saw how to configure the DNS on the router, and we saw how to configure the DNS server here in the packet tracer. But like I said, not realistic. You don't want to do that. One of the things you want to do is, let's say, if you're really just, you know, adamant about, oh, I can't do things by IP address, I have to do it by name, you can do static host tables. So I won't do it on this router. All right, and that's pretty simple to do. Again, won't take up any bandwidth, just your time. All right, no big deal. You can do it in a notepad and copy paste into it. It's not no biggie. So you're doing it, it's called an IP host table, IP host, and then here you put the name of the host. So let's say R3, and then the IP address is associated with me. So this would be 10.1.1.10 and 192.168.30.254. You can put up to 8 IP addresses. Oh, and then you can do IP host R2, and then it'll be 10.1.1.9, 10.1.6, and then 192.168.20.254. And let's do IP host R1, and then we have 10.1.1.5. And 192.168.10.24. These are the IP addresses that are associated with every interface. Now, in order for this to work, obviously, if you didn't know, you need to make sure you have connectivity, right? You're routing across the network. If not, it's not gonna work. Period. So, one of the first things that you do is make sure, you know, in any lab that you do before you start getting any kind of complexity in the lab, you want to make sure that you have connectivity. From your PC to the gateway, from router to router, and then once you do either static routes or a routing protocol, they have connectivity across your entire network. So you want to be able to check, you can ping from PC to PC to PC and anywhere and everywhere in the network, and then you can start doing whatever you need to do because you know you have connectivity. So it must be, if you have an error, is due to maybe a configuration or just that the simulator is just running slow. All right, so let's see what we can do here. Control C. So let's say it's ping R1. And you can see what happens. It's not looking. Before, it looked for the DNS server. It says DNS, and then it said the IP address of the DNS server. Now, when you do a ping R1, it says, okay, I'm going to go to this IP address. So it already knows the IP address is right there on the router. Ping R2. And then there's the IP address that it's using. And ping R3, which is myself. All right, and it's using 10.1.10. So again, that's just the first IP addresses that I put on there, and that's why it's using it. And again, you can put up to, I believe it's, if I remember correctly, it's 8 IP addresses, or however many, well, not however many, I think that's the max limit. But you want to put at least 3 IP addresses in case a link goes down, it'll use the other one. As a backup, whatever, something's going on, it'll have other IP addresses that it can fall back to. But this is something that's more for testing, to be honest with you. Really seeing this done in a real world environment. If they are, it could be done. It's not that it shouldn't be done. It could be done. Again, this is for people that just want to do it by name or for whatever reason. I personally am not a fan, but this is not what I would do. I do things, computers know numbers. Therefore, I do things based on IP addresses. Things are going to go a lot quicker. Even when I do shares, it's now we can do, backslash backslash server backslash share name. What I do is backslash backslash IP address backslash share name. That's how I do it. I know my network. So therefore, I know the IP addresses that are being assigned because you document that. And then if you do things based on IP addresses, the routers, the networking equipment, the equipment altogether doesn't have the added burden of trying to resolve a name to an IP. It just goes straight to that IP address. But again, if you're working in a large network and this is what you need to do, then that's what you need to do. Very easy to do. This versus DNS. This is something internal to the router that it's doing. It doesn't need to go out to look for any DNS server whatsoever. All right, so two things that you can do to do name resolution. You do either DNS or, as we showed here, a static host table. All right, And when we come back, the next lab, what we're going to do is, we got a lot of things done here. So we better copy our information, right? We better save it, not save it, because that's what the terminology has evolved in the past 20 odd, some odd years. So when you're saving on your computer, it used to be, on your router, it used to be called backing up, to NVRAM. But in the next one, we're going to show you how to really back up or copy it somewhere else, so you have multiple copies, all right, of your configurations. I'll see you then.